at this, see? Is that enough for you?
Brought to you in part by St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Strike King Lure Company, number one in fishing lures. Ardent, pure performance, all American. This week on Extreme Angler TV.
Attaboy, you got it on.
Whoa, Lordy, look at that, eh? Oh yeah.
So you can burn it, slow roll it, whatever, but it's made for heavy cover and a heavy rod and reel application.
We'll be right back.
This week I got a real treat for you, because it was for me too. I'm going to hook up with my buddy, Bruce MacDonald from Walls of Lake Lodge in fantastic Sarasota, Florida, fishing with Outriggers Sportfishing charters for amberjacks. We're going to stay at the Hyatt Regency Sarasota. They've got fantastic luxuries. It's great fishing, great food. I'm going to have a great time, and you're going to see some great footage, some big hard fighting fish from the Gulf of Mexico this week on Extreme Angler TV.
Now we're out here. Look at it. Beautiful in the ocean. Not even rocking and rolling. So we're going to go and I'm going to let Ryan explain what we're going to fish for, how deep we are, and how we're going to do it.
What we're doing here, Karl, is I got you positioned on a wreck. We're in about 82 feet of water. The fish we're after today is amberjack, and it seems like they're showing real well down there. We're going to be using live bait, drop them down to the bottom, and we'll see what happens.
What kind of live bait?
We're using today pinfish mostly. There's some blue runners. We got a little mixed bag. I think we got a few different kinds for you.
Yeah, you know, it's like planes, trains, and automobiles. It was almost like that today. We came from South Carolina with Patrick's truck, got on a plane, then got on Bruce's truck. Now we're out in the charter boat, and now we're gonna have some fun. Wow! This is hand-to-hand combat. Look at that thing. Oh yeah, I tell you. And like I said back at the dock, you know what? I had a special invite here from Bruce with the Hyatt Regency Sarasota. And you all know Bruce MacDonald from all of the Lake Lodge. We're up there in Tomogamy, but you know what? We ain't there now. It's way too cold for both of us. Bruce spends his winters down here, lucky guy. And we came out here with Ryan, and we'll hopefully catch some real nice amberjacks and different kinds of fish, red snapper, you name it. Whatever wants a bite, we're gonna catch it. But I get to spend some time here with Bruce again in the cold winters in Florida.
I prefer to hook him through the head. And you're just gonna come right up the bottom jaw, right out the top of the snout. That keeps them nice and lively. As they're going down to the bottom, they won't tangle you up too bad, and they can still swim around and be free, and we want them to look as natural as possible.
So we're fishing right on the bottom. We're lifting and dropping?
Yeah, we're gonna be dropping these all the way down to the bottom. These fish, they range anywhere from the surface to the bottom, but for starters, I always drop it to the bottom. It seems like that's where these baits naturally live. So we want them to be as natural as possible.
Good stuff. And you're just lifting off the bottom slow?
Well, just kind of take out the slack just so you can feel the tension on
gotcha.
The weight. And
so that little bait just went right off the bottom then?
Yeah, these baits are right on the bottom. And we'll try that at first, and if that doesn't work, we'll kind of change depths. The amberjack minimum legal size is 30 inches to keep, which puts that fish anywhere right around 20 to 22 pounds. They're pound for pound, probably one of the strongest fighting fish in the Gulf of Mexico.
Wow. So no cast, just let it swim back out?
You can flip it out a little bit, but usually those baits, they'll just kind of swim wherever they want.
And you're just thumbing it, right?
Yeah, just kind of feel that bait swimming around. And
how far much line you let out?
I just kind of keep letting it out.
Oh, okay.
You almost keep it in free spool, so if that bait wants to swim around, he can take it.
I see. And it's a little bit lighter weight, so it's not going to go to the bottom?
It'll still reach the bottom.
Okay.
But it kind of keeps it out in their strike zone a little bit longer.
I gotcha. Sometimes you just stop it so more pendulums, I guess, out too, right?
Yeah. Yeah, if you feel it get real nervous, you might want to hold it there for a second.
So they almost signal those bites too, don't they?
Yeah, they're trying to get away from those big amberjacks down there. The bait's getting nervous down there.
About 82 feet, right?
82 feet.
How much weight's on there?
We're using a 4-ounce lead. We run main 60-pound main line, 60-pound leader.
Oh! Was it? Like that? Oh, Lordy, look at that, eh? Oh yeah, you know you got a fish on when you're out here. Look at that. Get his head, try to turn. Wow, look at that, eh? I feel like Papa the Sailor Man. Oh yeah. Now I feel like the old man in the sea. Come here, you beast. Where are you going? Look at him. Good thing I'm braced. Wow. Look at that thing pull, man. Wow. This is hand-to-hand combat. Look at that thing. Oh, yeah, I tell you. Whoa, look at that. Oh, you better be in shape, boys. Because you will be when you're out here. I think he's coming up a bit higher now. Still wants to run. Look at that. Whoa, whoa. No kidding. Wow. There he is. Yeah, right about, oh, I can't tell how deep that is, but look at that. Wow. Holy cow. Whoa, buddy. Well, yeah, what a forearm pump. Wow. Let me put that aside for a second. Oh, man. Look at that, hey? Amazing, man. Outriggers.
Gulf of Mexico.
Out in the middle of Gulf of Mexico, catching amberjacks. Phenomenal. Wow.
These are great eating fish, too.
Yeah, but it's still probably short, you think?
This one's going to be real close. I think we'll let him go, maybe try for a bigger one.
Oh, wow. All right.
Okay.
Good stuff.
Great fish.
Now you talk about fight, unbelievable. I've caught big muskies, salmon, trout, steelhead, big smallmouth bass, you name it. I've yet to find anything that pulls as hard as these amberjack. That's the beauty of fishing with charter boats, you know. They put such an investment in all their equipment and experience and tackle and stuff. So guys like you and I can come out and just have fun.
Oh, buddy, just something else.
This time of year in January, whether it be South Carolina, or Sarasota, Florida, or wherever else in between, as long as I'm not home freezing, I'll be out here fishing.
Uh-oh.
Yes, sir, the drag screaming.
Oh, that's acting like a little better fish there.
Yeah. That's normal. That's normal for me. They're never easy for me. Oh, yeah, he's bigger. He's much bigger, yeah.
This is probably one of my favorite fish to fish for as well.
Yeah, man.
Oh, come on. Man versus wild.
Double header.
Coming your way, Bruce.
It's much bigger than normal. This is why I get addicted to AJs. I see him, he's a big one. Yeah, I see him. Look at the 12 of them around him. He's a lot bigger than he is.
fatter fish, isn't it?
Hey, Outriggers Sportfishing. Here, Florida, Sarasota.
Wow.
Beautiful fish,
Bruce. Karl, I think this is better than going to the gym.
No kidding, man.
There he is.
Hey, he's a bit bigger.
Oh, yeah.
Whenever you got something, you think we can.
I think that guy's a. That's probably a legal fish.
Yeah?
It's about minimum legal size here.
Beautiful.
We'll measure him up and maybe we'll take one back for a nice meal.
Yeah, man. I'm looking forward to that.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's a. 33 inches to the fork. That's a nice, perfect eating size. And I think he'll taste just fine. All right.
Didn't I tell you? Unbelievable. Ryan's got this pegged big time. You know what? I got a lot of respect for people who find their own fish. And for me, it's just about the fun to come down there. He's got all the rig, the big investment, all the tackle, the boat, you name it. You want some fun? You come down here and fight these big fish, just like me and Bruce. Because I'm telling you, they are a handful, and then some.
Wow! Look at that thing pull, man!
Hi, I'm Josh Haas, Director of Sales and Marketing at the Hyatt Regency in Sarasota. It's a beautiful hotel. It's a great getaway. You know, if you haven't been to Sarasota, it's one of those little gems on the west coast of Florida that not a lot of people have been to, but it offers a great, great source of fishing right on the Gulf of Mexico. If you're going to fly in, whether you're with friends or family, the airport is only about 3 miles away from the hotel, so it's really easy to get to. You know, the Hyatt Regency Sarasota, it's a downtown urban setting, but we're resort-like hotel. The hotel itself is only 294 rooms, so it's nice and intimate. It's a perfect getaway. We have a private 32-slip marina. You can rent boats out of here. You can, if you want to go fishing, you can go out with the anglers that we have on property. Or you can rent a boat and dock it and go out fishing yourself. There's lots to do. If you're looking for family and fun activities, we have a Laguna style pool, waterfalls going into it, zero entry, so it's just like being at the beach, but not, and nice cold drinks to be served up for everybody. Guys, if you're looking for a great place to get away and just have a boys' weekend, Sarasota is a great place to go. You know, not only are we located downtown, offering tons of nightlife and entertainment, restaurants, places to eat, who wants to go golfing all the time? You know, if you're coming here for a wedding or any other kind of social business, it's a great spot to get away and go fishing. You know, the Hyatt Regency Sarasota is a great, classy place to get away. You can still wear your flip-flops, still wear your t-shirts, and mingle with everybody in their khakis. We all have fun here. I hope to see you soon.
Stick around, we'll be right back. And now it's time for the Cottage Angler, presented by Lucky Strike. More fish fight with Lucky Strike.
Hi, I'm Greg Hackney. I want to talk to you a little bit today about a new line of lures in our heavy cover series by Strike King. It's the Strike King Heavy Cover Hack Attack Spinnerbait. The reason this fits in our heavy cover line is, number one, all the baits in that line are based around the Siwash style gamakatsu. This spinnerbait actually has a weight forward head. Comes with the perfect skirt, heavy wire. This is a spinnerbait that you can burn it, slow roll it, whatever, but it's made for heavy cover and a heavy rod and reel application. Big line, 20 pound fluorocarbon, 20 pound mono, braid if you wish to throw it that way. It's just a bait that'll really take a lot of abuse. You know, burning it on flats for big smallmouth. That big hook just really seems to, the hookup ratio is a lot better than it is on a standard hook. You know, a lot of times when you're burning a spinnerbait, those fish will have a tendency to hit the bait, and maybe not so much with their mouth open. You know, they just crush it and they get stuck everywhere, and that big hook will find a place to go in. One of my favorite ways for fishing a heavy cover spinnerbait, you know, around docks or grass beds or however I might fish it, you know, the first thing I'll do when that bait hits the water is I'll pop it, because then I'm dropping it. You know, I'm almost just letting the spinnerbait free fall down, and I'm picking up the slack as I'm rolling it in. And, you know, by doing that, what I'm doing, I'm able to fish from shallow to deep and cover all the water. almost like the same thing you would do with a crankbait, but I'm doing it with a spinnerbait. You know, and I find a lot of times, you know, the bite's bigger on a big spinnerbait than it is on a crankbait. Those fish are used to seeing that. You know, so I like to slow roll that spinnerbait around in places where, you know, a lot of guys are throwing a crankbait. But again, the first thing when I'm slow rolling spinnerbait, I'll do, because I'm not gonna start pulling it hard like I would if I'd burn it, make sure I can feel that spinner turning. And then basically what I'm doing then is just picking up the slack, and that bait is falling to that desired depth. You know, you'll feel that line drag over stuff, and when you pop it, a lot of times that's when you'll get to bite. It's when you deflect that spinnerbait.
Down to the abyss. A little bit different than drop shotting in 8 feet of water, isn't it?
Absolutely.
4 ounces of weight. Big fish looks like a pumpkin seed sunfish or shell cracker. But fishing for big brutes. Saltwater brutes are incredible, man. So tough.
They wear you out pretty quick.
Oh yeah. Like that.
Oh. Almost at the same time.
Whoa! Get out of there! Get out of there! Get out of there!
Got him now.
Yeah. Wow. Brace for the fight. After a couple fish, they feel a bit different.
Yeah.
He doesn't feel as heavy as the amberjack. He's still scrap good. Whatever
look
it is.
This. Look at this big snapper I got here.
Oh,
two
wow.
Big snappers. Big mangoes. How about that?
You can keep these?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, wow.
Absolutely. Oh.
Really?
That is a giant.
A giant. So red snapper.
Mangrove.
Mangrove.
And these are going to make you guys a great dinner.
Wow.
These are probably one of the tougher fish to catch. They got the fangs on them here, Carl.
Oh, look at that, man.
And, you know, they suck the bait in and spit it out.
Yeah.
And if I'm not careful, he'll bite me.
Okay, look at that. But, he wants to show his teeth. There he goes.
There he is.
Atta boy.
And you got an extremely large one. That is a beautiful, beautiful mangrove snapper.
Extremely large one.
Extremely large.
Wow.
For the extreme angler.
These are going to taste good, aren't they?
Absolutely.
Oh.
You're going to love it.
You're gonna love it. Man. I'm looking forward to this.
Yes, sir.
I can't get over this, man. In the box.
In the box.
In a meal. Now, you always see at home, you're always letting fish go. Come to saltwater, there's lots of fish. You know what? Ryan, you know, watches the rules and regulations of open seasons and you name it. But, I mean, we can take home fresh red snapper. What are they called again?
Mangroves.
Mangroves. And some amberjacks. Hey, I'm right there. Get re-rigged. Back down again. Whew.
It's hooked into something. Oh, something a little bigger, hey, Mr. Ryan?
Oh, that's a good one here.
The groupers come out for a second chance.
Oh, hey. That feels like a big 8 day or something there.
Hey.
Oh, hey. What?
Oh.
No. I think that's an AJ there.
She's a big AJ.
You know, and anybody can come out here and do this, Carl.
Yeah, it feels like a workout, man. It really does.
Ah, pretty fish. Pretty fish. Oh, there's one coming up behind him there. Well, that one got my forearms pumped up right there.
Wow. Yeah. They're straight from their eye backwards, too.
Yeah, yeah. It's real distinctive markings on the greater amberjack.
Wow. Another releaser?
Beautiful fish. Yeah, I think we'll let him go. I think we got enough for a nice meal.
Oh,
Yep.
Come on. Come on.
Hey.
She's coming up like a dead log, though. She doesn't know she's hooked yet.
Wow. I can't get over that brute force of those things.
She doesn't even know she's hooked. I see her. I saw her. I see it.
You see yours already?
Yep. Well, whatever, swimming down there, I see others.
Look at that. Wow.
Yeah, you catch three in a row and I'm ready for a nap.
Yeah.
No. See the, you can see the dark spots following them around down there.
Oh. No kidding.
He's a bit bigger.
Oh yeah. Look how big that is. Holy cow. Look at that.
Beautiful fish.
There you are, Bruce.
Oh boy.
Holy cow.
Sarasota, Florida. Outriggers, Karl Kalanka, no better.
Now is that extreme?
This is extreme angling right here.
Look at that, man.
That's a great fish.
Isn't he beautiful?
Beautiful. Beautiful fish. Good stuff.
I think we might go ahead and bring this on home with us too.
Okay. How can you beat that? How? Seriously. So I bet you're really popular with all the neighbors and you have your barbecues, eh?
I give a lot of fish away.
You do?
I give a lot of fish away.
Wow.
You make a lot of friends with fish.
Wow. I can't get over it. Look at you.
I'm
cardio.
Done. I'm worn out.
Whew. Unbelievable fishing. These fish pull and fight like there's no tomorrow. I just knocked off a couple more fish off my bucket list. I can't wait to come back to beautiful, sunny, warm Sarasota in January to fish with maybe Bruce, who knows, maybe even you'll be here. And a real big thanks to the Hyatt Regency Sarasota for treating us like kings. Listen, thanks for watching Extreme Angler. Maybe we'll see you right here in Florida next week. And a very special thanks goes out to Outriggers Sportfishing Charters, who provided some of the most exciting saltwater fishing we have ever experienced with those hard-fighting amberjacks. And to the Hyatt Regency Sarasota for the 5-star accommodations and hospitality in sunny, warm Sarasota, Florida. And if you want more Extreme Angler, go to our website, extremeanglertv.com, and I'm sure you'll find us on all your popular social networks, YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook, because I know you're gonna like us.